Evening all, so let's have some kicking dust fun now. Quite a lot's happened lately, and I think really this is all in preparation for planetary conquest, so let me explain. We've started an alliance. Now, if you're not familiar with what alliances mean, then basically it's a way to formally group players, or corporations rather. So you can have corporations of like 20 dudes and they're all best bros and they can have their own identity as a corp. And they can be part of an alliance, which is, I guess, a wider group of people. And they can and obviously share the benefits of the space, the district, the territory, whatever it may be. In my many, 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 many years of playing EVE, I've been probably part of most of the main alliances, certainly. And, you know, either overtly or covertly. And I've even had a go at running my own alliance at the same time as well. So this alliance is actually there as a collective of people, so there's no real law. It's not going to be autocratic or anything like that. It's going to be, well, maybe actually, but it's going to be generally a place where the middle and the smaller corps, which I consider ourselves to be part of, in terms of we've got about 500 people now, but we're not, you know, we're not a 2,000 man corp. But where those guys can basically group up and compete with the larger groups. It's also a bit of a mutual protection pact as well. Now we'll do a video on all this, but I just want to explain certainly why we've done an alliance. And certainly what the alliance means is, you know, to join it, you then get the mutual protections and bonuses and benefits of all the other good stuff. So it's worth considering. And it's an open invite. If you want to join, please do so. If you're a dicklord, you'll get kicked. So don't be a dicklord. Simple rules. Seems to work for most people. And I think really, you know, this is where, you know, you're going to have access to a huge group of players as well. So, you know, we're phenomenally active at the moment in all areas. Admittedly, we've not done court battles for the last few days, but I blame Kerbal Space Program for that. I'm addicted. I think what you're going to start seeing is, you know, with an alliance, you get a much larger group of players. Certainly for court battles, certainly for defense, and our objective is as simple as it gets. We want to go and own districts, and we're pretty much you know, committed to anybody who joins us. We will fight for you to have a district. We really will. And that's the group, basically the many, you know, fighting for the few. And that's it, really. That's the reason why we've done it. I think what I don't want to see, and I'm kind of, you know, I guess a bit sort of funny about this, but I don't want to see a game where, like, the, you know, only five corps own everything, because that pretty much would be, right, game done. You know, end level boss B and switch off. And, you know, the Planetary Conquest should be a repeating, reoccurring, dynamic, moving mobile game. Which is, you know, a lot easier said than done. In fact, it's not even easy, that easily said. But you get the point. It should be something that, you know, moves and shifts and so on. So having a group of players who are kind of just working together. I mean, again, you know, nobody really wants to be part of a mega corp. Well, unless you do. But I would say everybody likes to have their own identity. You know, generally most people are collectives of smaller groups. So, you know, if you don't want to join the corp, then, you know, feel free to join the alliance and you'll have benefit to the Dark Star culture in it. All its, well, whatever that is. I mean, you know, we'll play games with you. So that's it, really. I think, you know, if you're interested, please apply. Have a chat with Josh, Joshua Evil 666, because the process of getting your corp into the alliance is EVE based. So if you don't have an EVE character, then Josh will need to just walk you through that. But that's about it, really. So so in terms of news coming up, I did read somewhere that there may be around 250 districts up for grabs when the game first comes out, which is quite impressive. We've also started looking at our EVE assets as well, so we're rubbing our hands with glee in the premise that there's going to be lots of noobs flying around in destroyers in Malden Heath or wherever it is they do it, and we can basically go splat them quite easily with our you know, our band of rifters or whatever we choose. But I think it's, you know, it's a good point to bear in mind that, you know, with orbital bombardments is going to become a bit of a nightmare doing it safely. Okay, so maybe just have a consideration around that, because you know, you are going to get a lot, and I mean a huge amount of alliance, EVE alliance players who hate dust players. Let's face it, there's lots of groups out there that really resent dust people because of the nature of what the game represents. And I think really you're going to have to deal with those people who, quite frankly, are just going to love absolutely murdering anybody they come across in low security space. So just get ready for that. And we're looking forward to this, because this is going to mean a bit of a free-for-all as well. So Basically, the space, our district, and the space above our district belongs to us. So if you come at us, bro, we'll come at you as well with our Eve characters. And I'm looking forward to that immensely because it's just going to be amazing fun. So yeah, 250. The price for clone packs has gone up. So hopefully everybody's saving your precious little iskies. You're going to need probably 80 mil to buy a pack of 150 odd clones. And then those clones can be applied either to a base at home or you'll use them to actually project an attack. I don't know. I'm looking forward to finding out myself. But it's certainly looking that way. And I think, yeah, the price has maybe been upped a bit to make it a bit more restrictive. Again, there are probably corps out there who could spend, you know, 800 million. If ever they linked Dust with Eve and the Eve money came into it, pretty much we could just bombard. We could put a billion clones probably quite happily up in our space. And I think, you know, this is why I think with that little mechanic, I can't ever see probably how they're going to make that a linked game any ever, because, you know, I mean, I'm a relatively rich player. I think I'm worth about 1.5 trillion ISK, and if I put that into Dust, I could just literally just build up a wall of flesh literally on the map that means you'd never take the space. Do you know what I mean? So I hope they don't do that, because I'm not alone. There are hundreds and thousands of players out there who, you know, a billion ISK is a mere pittance. You know, you would tip your space butler a billion ISK, basically. And that's the worrying part of this, because I think if ever those links do, the financial links happen, which I hope they do, but maybe then the economy needs to be massively represented as well. So everything in Dust goes up 10% or something, or sorry, 10 times. But we'll see. I think it's going to be interesting to see how that pans out. So again, we've got an alliance now. Please feel to join us if you're interested. Come talk with us, come fight with us, come troll us, whatever is good. And I think certainly everybody should now be prepping for Planetary Conquest, and we certainly are. And there we go. So 22 and 5, I'll take it. It's a good score. Hope you enjoyed that. See you next time.